afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you! Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's... history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
So, are we done?
You won't be able to talk your way out of this, crooked man.
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this.
Of course it's right! This man tormented all of you, for profit! Georgie
Let
killed
him! Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course! Where are you going with this?
Well, by that logic, Miss White should be on trial for Tweedledum's murder, since you know Bigby works for her.
That's...
He killed a man.
Now, don't make him a murderer, for fuck's sake. Killing someone who's trying to kill you is hardly...
They were there to retrieve Crane. You didn't need to escalate things.
Me? It was them. And who sent those two freaks anyway?
Bigby and I have already discussed his behavior that night. We're handling it internally.
Now, where have I heard that before? How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
That was different.
Snow had nothing to do with it. We all thought she was dead.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for
mine. This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own crimes.
This isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen,
Everyone calm down. This isn't the reason we're here.
I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to
them. This is how it's always been.
This is what I'm talking about. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the-
Bigby? Miss White!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
She has something to say, and we're gonna listen. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
We need to establish some order here.
Vivian killed herself. Back at the pudding and pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think
Nerissa!
I know your...
My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty!
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
Maybe there will be more if he isn't stopped.
Hasn't there been enough blood?
So we get rid of him.
It's too dangerous.
Get him out of here.
We can send him
Everyone,
away.
Listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
This is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
You should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything.
What about Bigby?
What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine. Are you sure? This isn't how
it's... It's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff. Do what you think is right.
Teach him a fucking lesson!
No.
He has to die!
We can lock him
Just
away!
Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this way! There you are. I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep. Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already. You know, just between us, I was gonna let you live. But now...
You're going to miss me.
No, I won't.
For Lily and Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay, great.
This fucking line.
Oh, Mr. Wolf? Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin. Oh, Colin! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
Carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
I forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
It's just a farm. You don't have to be so dramatic about it.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so if you could bring it to her?
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry, TJ, but look on the bright side, okay? There's plenty of space to run around. A nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
I don't know. He must have run off.
Bullshit!
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out...
I had no choice. You have to understand.
You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Marissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
So you sold them out?
No. Yes. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club... Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this? Not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
So you think that makes it okay to lie?
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith. I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her.
So, that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah. I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
It's going to be different now, I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her. Or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other. And look out for us.
I go out there, and I do my job. I put my life on the line. I get shot at. I do what has to be done for them. But at the end of the day, I'm still the bad guy.
I know. But they'll come around. You'll see. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You protected your friends, no matter the cost. And you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I've been making a lot of mistakes lately.
But you've also done a lot of good. Don't forget that.
You've changed this place, for better or worse. Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too.
would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faye?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for. I'll see you around, Wolf.
Thank you.